Welcome to the Tennis Warehouse shoe review of the adidas Barricade 2017 Boost. Plush comfort gets taken to a whole new level in the Barricade 2017 Boost. A brand new knit upper is soft out of the box and naturally molds to the shape of your feet. For support and stability, adidas's Barricade 3D triangular midfoot chassis locks in the midfoot. Underfoot, boost cushioning in the heel provides long-lasting cushioning and energy return, while the Adiwear 6 rubber outsole is backed up by a 6-month durability guarantee. First up today, we have Jason. Now, Jay, I know you've worn the Barricade. It's probably going back to about the 3, I'm guessing. How did this latest 2017 Boost version work for you?
It definitely feels like a Barricade, and it reminded me a lot of similarities of the Barricade 2015-2016 version. But it was more comfortable. But for me, I needed about a good 6-7 hours of break-in because these shoes feel a little bit narrow. So I needed just to break in that arch, and I was getting some soreness in my midfoot and forefoot area. So after about 7 hours, that kind of went away. Performance-wise, it was great, just like I would expect from a Barricade. Great stability, support, very durable shoe. But probably my favorite aspect of this new Barricade would be the memory foam collar. It's just really plush and just adds another level of comfort that I haven't experienced in other Barricades. But overall, it's with the knit upper and the memory foam collar, like I said, it's probably the most comfortable Barricade I've ever worn, but unfortunately just a little bit too narrow for my feet.
Next up we have Troy. Now Troy, I know you're a fan of stable, durable shoes. This definitely hits those marks. How did it work out for you?
Yeah, the Barricades that I've tried in the past, I spent most time with the Barricade 6 and 7, and always been a really supportive, super stable shoe. I feel like this Barricade 2017 still has great support, great stability, but adidas has really gone in the right direction as far as comfort goes, because with the 6 and 7 and some of the older ones, just way too rigid, especially in the toe box. I used to get really bad toe jam. And now with these, I just feel like everything's so much more plush. The upper material feels great around the foot. The only real knock I had, and I know Jay kind of had a fit issue, but for me, it wasn't too narrow, but it was just, it didn't contour to my foot the way I wanted. It was really snug, locked in my midfoot and heel, but a little open in the toe area. So just a little bit of fit issue for me, but after I broke them in for about a week of playing in them, walking around in them, I really love the comfort. Durability was there, traction was there. I definitely have to say for a durability support shoe, this is probably my second favorite behind the Gel Resolution 7, which is still my go-to, but I really like what adidas is doing as far as improving the comfort.
I was also on this playtest, and I've actually worn every single version of the Barricade to date, and I'm a big fan of this latest version. Really like the way the upper fit around my foot. I like the way it flexed well. I didn't find the shoe require a break-in at all, actually, but I have a narrow foot, so I think that midfoot, tighter, more supportive fit through there was just a good fit for my shape of foot. Like Jay mentioned, I really enjoyed the fit around the ankle collar. It's really plush and comfortable, no rubbing or poking there at all, and that's rare for a shoe right out of the box. I could play in it very comfortably with no issues right there. Awesome support and stability. I love the durability as well. It's probably lasting me better than any shoe I've worn recently. Definitely lasts better than the 2016 version I wore, and I'm not sure if adidas have increased the amount of rubber on the outsole, but I'm just getting better wear under the big toe on my right foot, and that's my high wear area. I'm also getting nice durability on the uppers. And as Troy mentioned, the traction was spot on. I felt like I could slide out of an aggressive stop. Yeah, I had plenty of grip to get going to chase off that next shot. So a really fun playtest for me, and I just love this shoe. That's all we got for this version of the Tennis Warehouse Shoe Review. For all your tennis needs, be sure to head to Tennis Warehouse, Tennis Warehouse Europe, and Tennis Only. Thanks for watching.